Well, it's one of the biggest events that had happened in Salisbury. News of the fire went everywhere. I mean, the fire destroyed our newspaper. There was no newspapers to report on its own fire, but it was reported by Baltimore Sun and other newspapers.
On Sunday, October 17th, 1886, the city of Salisbury burned to the ground, leaving scenery like this as far as the eye could see. Linda Dwyer is a local historian who has researched the Great Fire of 1886. She works as the assistant director at the Julia A. Parnell Museum in Snow Hill, Maryland.
So by the 1880s, Salisbury had become literally a crossroads of two railroad lines, north-south, east-west, which linked up to the steamboats and the other boats on the river. That traveled routinely from Salisbury to Baltimore. So it was devastating because it had grown so much. All we know is that it was a livery caught fire. Just about any residence would have what they call a livery in the back where they would store their horses and their carriages and that sort of thing. The fire started in one particular livery, horse livery, on Market Street, and it quickly spread to businesses. It wouldn't take much for a fire to spread in Salisbury, and accelerants like groceries, stores, paint stores, liquor stores, they just accelerated all the fires. And then coupled with the wind, it just was unstoppable.
Now, the fire of 1886 is probably one of the most significant events to ever happen in a city. My name is Brian Rickards, an assistant chief, Salisbury Fire Department. I have nearly 40 years with the department. I help with a lot of historical information and research, mostly in this room here with the Historical and Heritage Center. In the fire of 1886, it was a different time. You know, when you looked at it back then, you had a lot of wooden structures very close, primitive, if you will. It was the largest city around, but yet still it had unique items as far as the wood structures very close. It wasn't unusual to find a pile of rags burning in the street or rubbish, you know. And eventually that's what led to the fire. It started right just about dusk on a Sunday evening. A lot of people were going to church, and when the bell was ringing, they thought that it was calling for the people to go to church in the evening. It was a ritual, and when it went off, they quickly determined that it was the ringing of the bell for the fire. They could quickly tell with the smoke and a lot of people frantically running, you know, to go into action. You know, the engine that you see behind me, it's an 1879 Silsby steam engine. At the time, it was a marvel, modern engineering. It had the capability of throwing hundreds of gallons of water. It was just perfect for what they needed. The problem with it was, when it came time, the fire in 1886, on October 17th, it had not been maintained. And when they arrived at the fire, it didn't work, and they never got it working until the next day. Having been to some pretty big fires myself, I can just imagine, and I would call it more of helplessness. You know, you have a piece of apparatus that in your mind you believe we're ready to go, we've spent this money, and we get there and it fails to work. You know, when you talk about the size of the buildings and the amount of fire they had, a bucket brigade simply wouldn't do it. You need something with a lot more pressure. It would be more of a hopelessness of not being able to do what you would really like to do to save your town. They sent the telegram out. They called for Crisfield, Wilmington, Pocomoke to come down. They would load the apparatus on what they called fast trains. But that's just not fast enough when you're sitting there watching your city burn down. You know, when you look at a fire like the Civic Center, which is probably the biggest fire that I've ever witnessed.
The main portion of the Civic Center, which was built 18 years ago, has been destroyed. Arriving firemen from Salisbury's number one and number two companies said the flames had spread from one end of the building to the other, and by that time they were unable to even approach close enough for effective firefighting.
On the day of June 27, 1977, the city of Salisbury, Maryland experienced a massive fire that destroyed the Wicomico Youth and Civic Center. The blue summer sky turned black. The scene was devastating.
You know, you had the potential loss of life with 62 children inside at a summer program that you see a picture with them running out the front door with a wave of fire as big as the building coming out. You know, that puts you in awe, because it doesn't matter what you come up there with. You come up with the biggest engine you want, the fire's already got a head start, and you're just going to have to go into a defensive mode. We operate generally in an offensive or a defensive mode. In that case, that was strictly defensive. There was no way you were going to save the building. You just couldn't put enough water on it. The fire had too much headway. The fire in 1886 was more of a defensive effort and setting up perimeters. They established that their priority was going to be the courthouse, which was not very old at the time. That was considered their gold nugget in the city. That was their pride and joy, and they elected that, okay, we're going to be defensive, but the courthouse, we're going to save that. We're going to put all our resources, and we're going to save it. Bucket brigade, whatever it takes. You know, that was kind of the mindset back then. And the only thing that really burned on that, a small scorch mark at the base of the tower near the clock. And that was it. They saved that building. The building's obviously still around today.
I think it just pretty much died on its own. There was another brick building at the end of Market Street, right on Main Street. It was a three-story brick building, but even it was mostly destroyed, which means that fire was fierce for it to have taken down most of a three-story brick building, although you still could see a shell of it. And if you see photographs of the fire, there's one particular photograph where you have a wide view of downtown Salisbury and the aftermath of the fire, and you see nothing but chimneys because all the buildings were wooden and everything was burned to the ground except the brick. Some of the brick, which so you'd see all these chimneys all over the place.
These chimneys serve as tombstones for a graveyard where a city once stood. Over 17 hours, the fire devoured 22 acres and over 200 buildings. Homes, businesses, churches, and schools were reduced to rubble and ash. Amazingly, no Salisbury citizen was killed in the inferno. When it was all over, the total cost was around $21 million in today's money. Only half was covered by insurance. The city was never the same.
They actually widened the streets. Initially, they wanted to go 5 feet wider on either side, and they got into a little bit of a discussion due to some of the existing buildings. It ended up being about 2.5 feet, but 2.5 feet over no feet was, you know, good progress. But it changed the layout of the city, changed the mindset. I think it, you know, basically let people know that, hey, at any time, what you have could be taken away from you. You can't take life for granted. But the fire changed the city for the better. After it was over, the city fathers and the citizens realized their mistakes. They made essential changes, moving away from wood buildings and going to brick and mortar. And within a month, they were already rebuilding back. And within a very short time, within a year, a lot of the city had been rebuilt. When you look at it from a historical standpoint, it was a real turning point. You know, you can often say that, you know, your city burnt down. You wouldn't see that in today's time, not with the modern firefighting equipment and technologies, but it changed it forever.
Well, the fire is what you see today. All the buildings you see downtown on Main Street are what you see from after the rebuilding, after the fire. There's only one photograph of Main Street ever taken that survives, showing Main Street what it looked like before the fires, which boggles my mind, but they probably all burned in the fire. There's only one photograph that shows it. So what you see downtown along Main Street and parts of Division Street, those brick buildings are like a snapshot in history of what Salisbury looked like after the rebuilding, after the fire. So.
While Salisbury doesn't look like a city its age, its rebuilding brought expansion. But the city has gone through more than just the Great Fire of 1886 to become what it is today.